used in this film has been developed in private, but I will explain at the end exactly how it worked. But first, back to our theatre. I needed to set the impact level of the subliminal film and decide exactly what effect that it should have.
I invited 6 volunteers to come and watch various versions of the subliminal film. I'm able to monitor them on CCTV cameras from a control room via a two-way mirror. Each film is very similar to the one you'll be seeing at home. They contain different subliminal elements at various strengths, which result in different reactions. From this, I'll be able to decide what to include in the final film.
Didn't really have any reaction. Maybe a wee bit dizzy at the start.
Sort of winking at you, it's almost kind of flirting.
Can you hear me at all?
It feels like something sort of almost holding it down, but there's nothing, I can't feel anything on top.
Slightly unexpected. Your hands are up in the air. Can you bring them down?
Not really. Like they're kind of attached to ropes, I suppose. It was odd. I can't really describe what I felt like.
This is sort of this is unusual.
Really horrible. I don't know why, it was okay to start off with, and then just got really intense, and the feeling of just like, I don't know, I just felt like I couldn't get away, and it's really overwhelming, I think.
Can you just stand up for me, just so I can just check that you can stand and... No?
No, I can't get up.
Trying out the different versions of the film told me what final tweaks had to be made before showing it to you at home and these people here. Now, after the break, I will play the film. We're all getting ready to watch it here, and I'd like you to do the same. I should point out that there are no flashes or anything you might associate with subliminals as such, and also the film is not effective at a lower resolution, so if it gets posted on the internet, it won't work. Now, the film is completely safe. However, some of you should not watch this film. Do not watch it if you believe you may be adversely affected. This is just to prevent any hysteria after the event. Or if you're under 16 and not accompanied by an adult. Equally, if you'd rather just not watch it for whatever personal reason, then don't. The film will only last a minute. You can look away from your TV as soon as it starts and then look back again after a minute and watch the rest of the show. So, if you would like to take part in this experiment, sit back comfortably in your seat with your phone and await further instructions. Welcome back. By now, hopefully most of you are sat in your seats, ready, and I'm about to give you the number so that you can phone in and tell us what has happened to you after you have watched the film. So, if you'd like to take part, put this number into your phone now so that you're ready to call, but do not call yet, as the lines are not yet open. Only call when instructed to do so after the film. The number is 03457 224 500. Callers from a BT landline will be charged a set-up fee of 8 pence per call, plus 3 pence per minute. Calls from other networks may vary, and from mobiles will cost considerably more. Now, for the film to be effective, you do need to be sat in a particular way, so please follow these instructions. Sit right back in your chair. Place your feet flat on the floor in front of you. Place your hands on your lap. Imagine a circle around your head with a radius of about a foot. This is your safety zone. Try and keep your head within that zone at all times. Your head must not touch that circle. And now remain in this position. Now, the film won't stick all of you, but it will stick those of you who are open to it, who allow it to work, those of you who have a well-balanced, bright, creative personality. And there'll probably come a point when you'll feel that you're either going to fight it or let it work. When that happens, just let yourself go with it. Just allow it to work. If you fight it, then it probably won't work, so it's kind of a waste of time even watching. Those of you with the best talent for responding to the film will find yourselves stuck, locked, glued, gelled, cemented, bonded, fused and welded into your seats. And the more you try in vain to unstick yourself harder and harder, the more you'll find yourself locking and sticking harder and harder into your seat. Think now which parts of your body are in contact with the seat. The tops of your legs, your back, perhaps your shoulders. Feel the weight of all of these. In a second, you will absorb the film. When you find yourself rigidly stuck, don't panic. Just allow yourself to enjoy it, to find it interesting, while you try in vain to unstick yourself as hard as you can. And you can imagine now what that would be like, trying to unstick yourself harder and harder. Just enjoy it. It's a very odd sensation. Now, others around you may stand, if you're watching with other people, which we found somehow concentrates the energy on you and then sticks you even more. So, take a deep breath in. And out, again in, and out. We're now ready to play the film to you at home and these people here. Let's play the film now. Now, as you sit there and as you find yourself sticking, remember to keep calm, try and keep your head within the zone, focus on the screen, let yourself be stuck. If you try to unstick yourself, you should find that the energy to do so somehow dissipates and all effort just washes away, leaving you motionless. So keep calm, focus on the screen. And the more you try to unstick yourself, harder and harder, the harder that you stick. And if you have been stuck to your seat by the subliminal film that we've just broadcast, we want to hear from you. And the lines are now open. Call the number that you have. It's 03457-224-500. Callers from a BT landline will be charged a set-up fee of 8 pence per call plus 3p a minute. Callers from other networks may vary, and mobiles will cost considerably more. We have operators waiting to take your call, and if you do get through, you could be speaking to me on air. Unfortunately, we do have a limited number of operators, so not everyone will be able to get through, and the lines will be closed as soon as we have all of our callers. So remain as you are for a few minutes while we see how our friends here are doing.
Take a moment. Just try and stand up. See what happens as you start to try. Just try to stand. Just try and push yourself up. And this tends to happen. The nearer you are to the screen, the more powerful it is. Put some effort into it. Really hold on to the sides of your seat. Really do try. Really do try. Just... And if you're finding it frightening, it's just...
I'm beginning to panic a little bit.
Are you? Yeah. You're beginning to panic
a
little
bit? My heart's going a bit fast, but it's okay.
So what happens when you try? What's your kind of experience of this?
I just feel heavier now. My elbows just feel really stuck.
Okay.
To the chair, and particularly my back is the heaviest I think it's ever been.
Okay. Best thing to do, if you're really feeling that, if you're starting to feel very odd, just relax and go with it. How's it feel?
I can't feel my legs.
You can't feel your legs?
I can't feel my legs.
If I do this, can you feel my hand?
No.
No? We'll talk to some people at home in a minute, but you're all, presumably, you're aware of the fact that it's just an ordinary seat. There's no reason. What's it like? What does it feel like?
It's just bizarre. I'm trying very hard to get up.
Yeah.
I just can't get up. My legs feel very heavy.